In this video, we will be printing this pattern in greater than or equal to 4 ways and basic to advanced. So let's call it method 1, and we are going to use two loops, the most basic way, one for the rows and the inner loop will be for the columns, alright? And use the print statement to print the values in it. Now let's type the values in the range. So the outer loop has to execute 5 times, one each row, okay? So let's start it from 6 to 1 not included and with a decrement of minus 1, because we are going from 6 to 1 in the reverse direction. So it will go from 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. So we have 5 rows, so it will go 5 times. And in the inner loop, here you can see that the values are changing. So in the print statement, we have to use J for printing, and in the range, we are going to start from 1 and end at I. I will make you understand this in a little of while. Let's make it first end equals in a single quotes a space to separate each of the columns with a space. Enter backspace and use the print statement here so that you have a next line after execution of this inner loop. Because of this end, you are not able to start a new line. All of the iterations will be printed in the same row. So that's why we have used this print statement here after the execution of this code. So let's understand this one. When I is equal to 6, the inner loop will go from 1 to 1 less than 6, okay, that is 1 to 5, and it will be printed like this, as we have the print statement here to print the values of j from 1 to 5, okay. And when I is equal to, in the next iteration, it will be 1 less than 6 because we have minus 1 here. It will be 5. Then j will go from 1 to 1 less than 5 because I is not included here. So it will go from 1 to 4, and the same will be printed like this and so on. Okay. And let's execute this now. And here you can see that we have the required pattern. Now in the method 2, we are going to reduce the number of loops. And we will only be using a single loop. So let's start it from I is equal to 6 to make it more easier for you, and use a while loop until I is greater than 1. Okay, I'll be making you understand in a little while, just wait, and use a print statement here. And now just use star range to print the elements from 1 to I, and decrease the value of I by 1. Okay, now let's understand this. I will be equal to 6 in the first iteration, greater than 1, good. Now this star range will print all the integers starting from 1 and 1 less than I, because I is not included here. So it will start from 1 and will go through 1 less than 6, that is 5. So it will print 1 to 5 here, it will be decremented, then I becomes 5, greater than 1, then it will print the range of elements from 1 to 1 less than 5, okay, not included. So 1 less than 5 is 4, so it will print the elements from 1 to 4, and so on, okay. And let's execute it now, and here you can see the same pattern we got. Now in the method 3rd, we are going to use a string here, which contains 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 as its characters, and using a for loop with the enumerate function for I, j in enumerate, and in parentheses type s as the argument, and use the print statement here. And in the print statement type star s, so it will print all the elements of s, but we don't want all the elements of s to be printed, we just want these many elements in the first, then 1 to 4, then 1 to 3, and so on, okay? So we are going to use slicing here in the square brackets, and here we want to go from, just don't type anything in the first value of the slicing, because we want to start it from 1 in every iteration, okay? And we want it to go till last in the first iteration we are talking about. So the last will be, let's know the value of I and J here first. So I will be the index of the string per character. So I will be starting from 0 to 4 as we have 5 characters. So it will go from 0 to 4 and j will be the value at that index. Okay. So the value here will not be included. So we will be just subtracting it from 5, I, 5 minus I. So in the first iteration, I equals to 0 and 5 minus 0 is 5. So fifth index will not be included. So it will go one less than that. So it will start from 0th index and go until the 4th index. Okay. So we will be having all the elements in the first iteration. In the next iteration, when I is equal to 1, it will go from 0th index from this character until 5 minus 1, that is 4, and 4 will not be included. So we will be having third index. Okay. So it will go from 0th index to the third index, 0, 1, 2 and 3, third index. So we will be having this 1, 2, 3 and 4 printed. So let's execute it. And here you can see that we have the same required pattern, same here and same what we wanted. And now in the method 4, we are going to further reduce it to just 2 lines and a single loop. We'll be using a for loop for that, for I in range. So we will be executing it 5 times. So we will be just using 5 in the range and I will iterate from 0 to 4 as 5 is not included. And write the print statement here. And in the print statement, we'll be printing the range of elements from 1 to 6 minus I. So in the first iteration, I is equal to 0 and 6 minus 0 is 6. And as per the range function, the 6 will not be included. The second argument will not be included. One less than that will be included. So it will print all the elements ranging from 1 to 1 less than 6, that is 1 to 5. And in the next iteration, I is equal to 1. It will go from 1 to 1 less than 6 minus 1, that is 1 less than 5. So it will printing the elements from 1 to 4. Okay. So let's execute it now. And here you can see the same pattern we got. So we have just reduced this 4 lines and 2 loops code into just 2 lines and a single loop. More efficiency and less number of lines, decreasing the program size. Okay. Please subscribe to support PyProTricks, and that's it for now.
Thank you for watching. Now it's time to discover more. Simply click on the screen to subscribe to our channel and watch another video to discover more.